garlic salt.
Man, if y'all hadn't had any, y'all need to stop by and get some.
Right up the middle, Panther line is blocking, pushing them out of the way, and that's Gordon straight up the middle for the Panthers. At offensive line, Jackson Henderson, I don't know, 45. I got to get that. You got 66 up there. That's Murray, the center. Panthers are coming off the ball well. That'll be a first down. That's first and gold on the 7-yard line.
If I'd have known he was bringing wings, I wouldn't have had that whole bowl of chili. I'd only eaten half of it.
Make it to halftime. Here come the Panthers. We're going to run the counter back to the wide side.
I think he's going to get it, Allen.
Touchdown. He got in, and that is number 3, DeMondre Edmonds. So the Panthers get the onside kick, and they drive 60 yards and about 7 plays to go up 6-0 here with 10 minutes to go in the first.
Allen, I'm trying to find Creek Box Live.
You might as well give it to Daniel and let him hook you up over there.
I can figure it out.
All right, there's a shot of the Panther crowd. That'll bring Robbins on to kick. They take the snap. Oh, they got a piece of it, but Robbins will get it across, Tom, and that's going to make it 7-0. Panthers lead.
All right, Allen, well, it's 10 minutes left to go in the first quarter. We'll take a break while they get ready for the kickoff.
You're watching Backroad Sports on Creekbox TV.
There's a reason why we're South Georgia's automotive superstore.
Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram. Chevy.
Nissan on the east side.
Walker Jones Used Car Mega Center.
GMC.
Coming soon, the all-new Walker Jones Honda.
Toyota.
We've got it all, so why shop anywhere else?
All right, Tom, we're back now. Panthers lead 7-0. You got it hooked up yet?
No.
Man, you got people on. Give that to Daniel and tell him to hook us up to the thing. I got it pulled up somehow. Lexi usually has to get on there for me. All right, Robbins will come out and kick off for the Panthers. Pretty opening drive, Tom. Went right down the field. See what the Indians are going to do.
Zach sees him kick it in the end zone, Allen. He's about 30 yards back.
Get out of the way.
Get out of the way. I'm coming through.
You got a long running start. And he's going to.
I told you.
Man, he did all the way down to
about the
3-yard line. Now here come the Indians. Going to bring it out. Number 4. Good job by Tiller to hold his ground. And that's Keith Harris for the Indians. And he's going to bring it out, what, talking about the 22? So
I got it on a basketball game, Allen. Creek Box.
That's got to be last year. All right, Tom. There we go.
I respond to people now. Miss Martha Blaylock's watching.
Always.
Yep.
Always.
Kingsport. No. Woo. She's watching from Las Vegas tonight.
All right. The blackjack tables out in Las Vegas.
Put us $100 on black
there
on roulette table. If you win, I want 50.
Yeah.
If you lose, we'll spot you later.
Yeah. We'll give you some of these wings we got.
Yeah.
There goes Charlton. He's going to run it right off the tackle, and the Panthers will eat it up, and that is Gus Bryan on the tackle.
And man, we got a shout-out to the Panther mascot, Zakoria Ganey.
All right.
He does a good job.
He does.
Always leading the Panthers out, coming through, to busting through the sign.
And we got Gus starting at outside linebacker tonight for the Panthers. It's left linebacker. Willie's flopping back in too. So.
I saw Trini today.
Man,
Robert Jabbers.
They had a great picture, Trini and Dooley and Gus did. They posted on Facebook today. And there's another handoff, and the Panthers will wrap him up at the line of scrimmage, and that is number 9 for the Panthers, and that is thrower. What a good looking boy. You're looking Hodges, 78. I wish we had our weights down here, Tom. You got to figure if the other one weighs 340, Hodges got to be pushing 350.
He's got to be.
It finally feels like football weather, man. All right, Indians break the huddle. They come out in a spread. Three receivers to the top, one to the bottom. One back set. Panthers in a 4-2. 18's going to take the snap. He's looking.
Got
looking.
All day to throw it.
All day. He's going to get outside, Tommy's got room. He's going to go. Ooh. There's a crack back, and that's going to be a 15-yard penalty. You cannot hit a defenseless player now, so that's going to back the Indians up, and that's what he did. It was a blind side on trying to see who that was over there. So he had the first down for Charlton, and that is Jalen King, the quarterback. And I know Charlton's coach is it wasn't a clip, Tom. I think
it wasn't a clip.
Block.
It was a clean block. It's just
you can't block that way.
You almost it's almost you just can't hit that hard.
Yeah, I mean that's basically what they're saying. You cannot if his eyes is not turned around and can see you coming, that's a 15-yard penalty, and that's what it's gonna be. So that will back the Indians up. They'll do third down over. And that's gonna make it third and about 15. Good job in there by the Indian quarterback. Done a great job to get out King. He had all day, and then he scrambled out. Tom, that hurt the Panthers last week over there in Lanier.
Yep. I'm reading the comments. I think Lexi Hanley's snaps or whatever it is has been hacked. She said, go Charlton. I think she's just trying to mess with us. Shout out to Michael Walker.
All right. There's the Panthers. They stop him at the line. Good tackle in there by number 45.
You know, Ashley Colburn said she was able to watch senior night all the way from, is that Qatar? Where's
Man,
that? Q-A-T-A-R?
My brother.
That's a long ways from Homerville, Georgia.
That's over there. That's over by Iran or somewhere over there.
I think
Daniel,
so. Daniel, where's that?
You got 4 degrees.
You ought to know where it's at. It's far away. It's far away. I've already said it's far away.
You go to red light and hang left.
That's right.
Indians will be punting. Good snap. You're going to put it down, and, oh, he shanks it off the left side of his foot. Panthers will scoop it up, and he's going to pick up about 10 yards.
Moorhead's hard running.
Is that Moorhead? Man, that was
isn't
some
that
hard.
Moorhead?
Yeah, you're right.
Tina Andrews said her old red roll to Gus Bryant and Tyler Moorhead from Savannah, Georgia.
Yeah.
Over on River Street.
Man, she's had some great kids to play over here in Homerville, too.
Yeah. No, Ashley Colburn said yes. That must mean it's a long ways from Homerville.
That's right. Here come the Panthers again. This is their second possession. First one, they drove 60 yards to put 7 on the board. Break the huddle, got wing to the left. Charlton's got 9 in the box, right up the middle. Michael Walker, he's going to pick up another first down, Tom.
Good hard running yards, Alan.
Great blocking in there by that Panther line. Murray, 64 in there. That's Jamarcus Marshall.
It's next to Saudi Arabia.
All right.
And that's not Arabia Bay in north of Clinch County either, where I'm from.
We got an Arabia.
Yeah, we got an Arabia. That's Arabia Bay. It's not out there in Arabia Bay. Well, you be safe over there, Ashley.
There's not many pine trees on that neck of the woods.
Oh, Cindy Corbett says she's watching from the practice field. It's too cold.
Yeah.
She's out there. It's too cold to walk up here for Cindy.
Hey, her and Matt, partner. Yep. We're going to throw it again, Tomo. Excuse me. That's our second pass tonight, so we're opening it up a little bit. It was there. Good job. Michael rolls to the left, and he's looking for Moorhead, and he just led him a little too far. They even had number 10 wide open, and Perry Williams was open right down the middle of the field. So, man, that's good to see the Panthers passing the ball a little bit now, working on stuff for later on.
Well, Danny Ellis, shout out to his favorite senior cheerleader, Natalie Young.
All right, man.
Uncle Danny's proud of you. John Raspberry, congrats to the U.S. Marine who came out with the team. Roll, red, roll.
Oh, the Panthers put it in. We're going to scoop it up, Tom. Great hit in there by number 6 for Charlton. That is Marshall Maxwell. And, man, but it looks like it was played that way. He just scoops it up.
kept going with it.
And the Marine was Dustin
Hendricks. Graduated today, didn't he?
That's this morning.
Man, we were watching. Emily was watching something on Facebook that his mama was posting yesterday or the day before, and was about 15 feet from him, and he couldn't look at her and couldn't talk. He was in line, and he wasn't cutting his eyes over at her. Emily said, "I don't believe I could have done that." I said, "Oh yeah, you wouldn't have messed with him."
Yeah, no. Here come the Panthers. We're gonna run a blast off tackle.
Good there. Blocking.
Yeah, I mean great blocking. Tom, me and you can run.
I was fixing to say that. You and I could be running through that, Alan.
Big Dozier out there blocking. 75 for the Panthers. That is Drake Browning on his side over there.
I bet we could slip out here to practice field and get a picture of Cindy and Matt. I bet there's Cindy sitting right there beside him, right there in the front seat, like in the high school, riding around the Dairy Queen together.
Matt's complaining.
Yeah, Matt's complaining. Yeah.
I know he is. We can do this at the house. All right, gonna come up and go to the concession stand and eat on Friday night. It counts as a date.
Yeah, that's right.
Matt, I'm trying to take up.
And if he'll keep her out there until about the fourth quarter, he doesn't even have to pay to get her in.
No, that's right. All right, the Indians bow their backs. Good tackle in there by number 6 for the Indians, and that is Maxwell again. He made the hard lick a while ago that squirted the football out.
You know, Charlie Moorhead's watching from Atlanta.
Reckon who she's watching.
Yeah, I know. Everybody knows who she's watching. Shout out to Tyler, number 1. Cindy Corbett said, "I hear y'all."
You know, Tyler's been kind of banged up the last month, Tom. It looks like he's getting over his soreness.
And
running the ball well. The Panthers overload to the left. This time Walker's going to fake it and keep it. Oh, great move there. Good block in there by 45. Charlton recovers number 50 for the Indians, and that is.
We got to find out who 45 is, Alan.
Akbar. I reckon that's how you pronounce that.
Yeah. Yeah. Asad Akbar.
That's what I thought.
5'10", 220.
And he just laid the wood. There's a shot of the man. The Indians have a great bank.
Yeah, they do.
We had to shut the door. Yeah.
Hot in here. We had to shut the door.
Anytime you got 3 tubas,
it's gonna be loud. And they're all on this side, and it's facing at us.
I think did they jump offsides on the Indians? That'll move them up 5 more, Tom, or half the distance. Nope, 5. You're right. So it's 1st and goal from the 4. There's a.
Who?
I'm just trying to think of his name. He played linebacker for me. Works out there with Kennedy. I'll think of it here in a minute. Standing on the fence. There goes number 1.
Untouched.
Moorhead makes it look easy. Which, Tom, the line is just
doing a great job, Alan.
13-0.
Yeah, 13-0. It's 4 minutes left to go in the first quarter.
2 possession, 2 scores. So Robbins is going to come out. They got a piece of the last kick, Tom. Robbins didn't get a lot of air up under it. I don't know if it was
Marcus Hodge.
Hodges, that's
Zeb
it.
Hodges.
Yeah,
yep. Zebulon Johnson's
sent it in.
He's Marcus Hodges.
Yeah. I couldn't imagine. A good linebacker. There's a good kick.
Good kick. He kicked that almost to John Bass's backyard over there.
He did.
All right, Alan. Well, that's 14-0, so we'll take a short break. Be right back.
Hi, I'm David Johnson, pastor at Trinity Baptist Church. Man, Jesus has dramatically changed my life, and I want you to know he'll do the same for you if you'll give him that opportunity.
Attention all hunters, Homerville Feed and Seed has all the shelled corn you need to bag that buck this year. Drop by and load up with corn, shotgun shells, food plot products, and everything else you need to make this year's hunting season the best ever. Whether you're a blueberry farmer or a backyard gardener, we have a wide variety of fertilizers and seed for you. There's no need to drive out of town when all the ag products you need are right here at Homerville Feed and Seed, Homerville, Georgia.
It's called old age, Tom.
It's called that wreck.
Yeah. Got a crink in your neck.
Man, if I sit still, I can't. It hurts. I move around. We've been working on tree planters all week at the shop. Man, I'm hurting. What?
Oh, and hot chocolate burgers in the box.
Oh, yeah. Y'all want one? Yeah, I got them for y'all.
All right, Ed Robbins, he's going to kick it deep. Good kick, Tom, inside the five. And Ford's going to bring it out again. A good return. He's up to the 25, 26, 27-yard line. And that is Keith Harris for the Indians. Indians had a good run a while ago, but had a illegal block, and that backed them up 15, and the Panthers took over.
There's the student section.
They all decked up.
Decked in camouflage, I think.
I was looking for Thomas and Taylor.
There's Taylor right there.
I knew they were somewhere in there.
Yeah, Thomas.
Hey, which
Thomas
one had
is, Thomas is probably sitting up there with his mama.
Yeah.
He had
appendicitis
this week.
Oh, man, we hope he's
Man, that little fella was hurting bad. Man, that's.
He's been milking it, hadn't he? Has he went to school this week?
No, he ain't going to school yet.
Yeah.
I don't blame him. He didn't need to go to school. He'll go next week.
There you go. All right. He's going to scramble and he gets down.
Old boy takes after me. He's got straight A's. He can make up his work.
Yeah, but did he go hunting any this
no,
week?
No, he's no joke. No, he's been around the house.
Harris will pick up a couple of yards. He scrambles out of it. Good job by the Panthers. Keep him hemmed up.
Eric Sutton's watching from DuPont.
All right. Big city of DuPont.
He'll be waiting on you over on your front porch. Y'all can talk about the game after the.
And it's about time for your daddy to call you.
Yeah. I hadn't checked my phone.
Yeah. He's watching.
I'm sure they're watching from the 8 Mile Steel.
That's right.
I don't know if they came tonight or not. It was senior night.
Oh, I bet they came, Tom.
Oh, no, it's cold, man. He might not have.
Good run in there by number two, Lilly. He was looking for somewhere to go, but the Panthers had him all wrapped up. Number seven, DeLeo Carter, in there leading the way for the Panthers.
Roll red roll from Fountain, Colorado. Man, I wish I was in Colorado.
Fountain, Colorado. I bet it's cold out there tonight.
Oh, Joe C., Williston, North Dakota. He's watching.
All right, Joe, how cold is it out there?
Yeah, how cold is it, Joe? Lawrence Middleton's watching his nephews from Warner Robins.
All right, man, we got them all over the place tonight. Eyes, that's it. Gonna scramble on third down, Tom. The Panthers, the secondary, doing great. Number 18, the quarterback for the Indians, King, nowhere to go. Panthers are playing great defense tonight. They hadn't gave up a first down yet. So the Indians will come back to punt again. Big 99 in there for the Panthers now.
Fourth and nine.
Big Greg.
Yep.
He's not even getting down. I'd hate to be in
front of him. I would, golly.
He's in a sprinter's stance.
Yeah.
Thank God he didn't rush. He's going to – that's a lot better punt this time. Did it hit him, Tom? I thought it hit one of
them. I thought it hit one of them's ankle, but.
This is a lot better punt, but the Panthers will take over on their own 32.
Man, Alan, I want to take a minute. The last day of voting is the last day of early voting was today.
Uh-huh.
So the election's Tuesday. And even if you're in the county, if there's nothing for you to vote on, you can still go vote for this East Block.
That's right.
And I know that we've been getting school calls from the schools about it and how important it is. I think it's going to do good, but you never know. So you got to get out and go vote. Vote yes on the East Block, because without it, I mean, it could cripple our school system.
And your taxes are going to go up.
That's right.
There's no denying that. Another good hard run in there by number six for the Panthers. That's Grady again. Good blocking in there.
I'm going to try to get Lori James, the new and upcoming superintendent, to try to come in here right before halftime.
Good, man.
And I got a little bit of pull with her sometimes, but she can also ship mine telling me no.
That's right.
You know, but get her to come in here right before halftime, or either Mr. Jason Bell and come talk to us
a little bit
about it.
Panthers going to run it right up
man,
the middle. That's
out,
Tiller.
They never touched
him. No, that's Dorsey right up the middle. Them big thighs. Man, they never, you're right, Tom. Look at that blocking. Great job in there by that Panther line. All the way down to the Indian 28.
He said it's 38 at the moment. It's a heat wave.
38?
Yep.
Man, it's almost out here. I think when I pulled up, it was 51.
Yeah.
I bet it'll get down to about 20 out there tonight. Problem out there, it, once it gets cold, it doesn't warm up till Easter. it's cold forever.
Man, one day I'm going to buy a little bit of land out west somewhere like that and build a cabin.
Man, that'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Go out there during the summers when it's hot here. Hey, go out there when it's cool.
We got.
I want a horse and a cow. That's one of each.
We got Coach Carroll waiting on the sideline here after the first quarter. We're going to get it off, and we do. Moorhead's going to throw it, and we will complete it.
Good bullet pass.
It was.
Can you hear me, Daniel?
Yep, we can hear you,
we
Tim.
We got you, Tim. Come on, brother. Tell us what you got.
All right, folks, got one quarter in the book here. Clinch County 14, Charlton County nothing. Clinch took advantage of a couple short fields, a punt, and an onside kick. Clinch's offense looks pretty strong. Charlton County had a long run taken away with a blindside hit. But anyway, we got one in the books. It's 14 to nothing after the first quarter.
All right, Coach Carroll, you can see it's cooled off. He's decked out with gloves.
And pants.
Yeah.
He's got shorts on.
Yep. So we'll change into the fields, Tom. So, man, that's good. You're going to get one of them in here to talk about the splash.
Yeah, I just texted Lori. She says she's going to come in right before the half.
All right. And if y'all have any scores around the area, text them in to Tom. Let us know what some of them are. There's some exciting games tonight. Like we said, I know Lowndes and Moultrie's playing. I think when you get later in the year like this, all the big games are played.
Yep.
The rivalry, you know. It's just like college. That's one thing. When Charlton and Clinch plays, it's usually right with the Georgia-Florida game.
So, yep.
And I know Frankie's watching. Got to give him a shout-out.
He's trying to watch a team win tonight that he supports.
Yeah, you're right.
He won't tomorrow.
Man, look at there. Great blocking, good balance by Moorhead. Man, he just makes it look so easy. Watch this right here, Tom. Great blocking. Watch him. They should have had him there, and he picks up an extra 10.
Well, Antonio Jefferson's watching from Seattle, Washington.
Whoo!
He couldn't get – how cold is it there?
Yeah. About 10 more feet, he'll be out in the ocean.
Ashley Colburn. She said, y'all quit yawning. Or you must have been yawning. I don't think I've been yawning. She said, y'all quit yawning. It's 02. It's 2:56 where she's at.
2:56. Good Lord. That's good late. Job by Moorhead. He'll fake it. I thought he was going to hand it off, and he'll get inside the five.
Shout out to my family, number 42, 1, 6, 10, and 14. She's related to half the team. And the rest of the Panthers from Buffalo, New York.
Buffalo. Man, I lived out in Kenmore, New York. That's in Buffalo.
Really?
A little suburb there in Buffalo, man. Panthers, I think, moved, and that's going to back them up 10 yards, Tom. They were inside the five. Nope. Must be a five-yard penalty. I don't know what the call was. Mr. Bobby probably called it, but me and Tom wasn't paying attention, so that'll crank the clock back up. We're just starting the second quarter here in Homerville.
I believe we left a little early.
I think we did
too. Must not have called it, though.
And Grady all the way down to about three. Tom, I'm like you. I thought the back beside him.
I thought he left a little early, but.
Right, he's all the way down to the two.
I mean, we're right. They just missed it.
Yeah, that's right. You can see a lot of the fans from Charlton showing up now. Their side's picked on up. Here come Panthers. They're going, good job in there by 15 for the Indians. That is Caleb Milton. And if he's a Milton, I know he's a good athlete because there have been some good ones at a Charlton.
Man, it's only 29 in Seattle, Washington.
Yeah, but it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon out there probably. You know, that ride up to, 4 hours or something like that behind us. It's going to get pretty cold tonight.
It's not going to get that cold here.
No, I think we're supposed to get down about 45, something like that. Panthers break the huddle, wing to the right. Moorhead will hand it off up the middle. Great job in there by the Indians.
Indians are bowling back at the goal line, Alan.
Man, they are. Grady tried to run. Great job in there for the Indians. Number 12, that is Wittenberg.
Who's Brandon that guy Wittenberg. Back there with the camera, Alan?
That's one of the Indian coaches. They do have the end zone camera now. We have one also that I don't know if Mr. Barron and him put it up tonight. Pretty good angle. Fourth and gold here, Tom. Panthers going for it. There goes Moorhead right up touchdown. Man, they just had that blast to right side of that Panther line, come off the ball, touchdown, 20-0.
20-0, Alan. Mr. George Bassinet said Irwin's up 19-0. And Daniel, before I forget it, he's got some computers he wants you to work on. I've got his number if you don't.
If Daniel can't fix it,
it can't
throw
be fixed.
It in the trash. Man, my phone, I don't even have to charge it for 2 days now. I had to charge it every 20 minutes before I took it to him. All right, Robin's back in the game, Tom. There's the snap. It's put down and straight through the uprights.
All right, that's going to put the Panthers up 21-0 with 9 minutes and 13 seconds left to go in the first half. We'll be right back.
Winkie's Southern Styles in Homerville is the go-to place for custom embroidery and vinyl transfer designs. Whether it's T-shirts, caps, or special Christmas items, Winkie's will make it happen. Go by our location at 44 East Elna Street in Homerville and see Lenora for embroidery and vinyl transfer. Winkie's Southern Style supports the Panthers in their quest for another state championship. Go Panthers!
Dairy Queen is a proud part of our local communities and is cheering our sports teams on to championship seasons. Drop by before and after the game to say hello to Mr. Ash and his entire crew and enjoy the full Dairy Queen menu, including our famous grilled burgers, artisan style sandwiches, and chicken strips. Cool off with our renowned smoothies, slushies, malts, and iced coffees. Try our fabulous desserts and take an ice cream cake home for that special occasion, or just to treat the family. Dine in or take out at Dairy Queen locations in Homerville, Blackshear, Folkston, and Fernandina Beach. See you at the DQ.
All right, Tom, we're back here, Clinch County, here in Homerville, Georgia. We got a Region 2A battle between the Panthers and the Charlton County Indians. And the Panthers are up 21-0 here early in the second. There's a deep kick. That's going to come up shortest one tonight. He got it on the 6. Great tackle in there by the Panthers. What number is that? Is that, who is that, 13 or 33?
33.
Hustled down the field. That is Danny Fontaine. There's Kara Sue, Miss Levington, all the cheerleaders. They got their Letterman jackets on tonight. They've waited all year to wear them. All right, the Panthers have yet to give up a first down to the Indians. Charlton, they're in the spread formation, a one-back set. Panthers are in a 4-2. There's a snap. He's going to pull it, and he's going to run, and he'll pick up about 3 yards. That is King, number 18 for the Indians. No, that might have been number 2. Where's him?
There's the Hendricks.
That big Walt.
Jamie's pointing at him.
Jamie, we made him famous.
There's Walt. Yep.
Look at Walt waving.
There's Dana.
Hey.
Tiffany.
And there's
right?
Swampy up there with his suspenders on. All right, 2nd and 7 now for the Indians. Brad does a good job with the camera getting Everybody gets excited. There's a pass. Oh, boy, that was a great job. I thought it was going to be a pick six, Tom. Great catch in there by number nine for the Indians, Zurin Williams. So that might be the Indians' first down on the night, and it is. They'll move the chains. They need a drive here. There's Coach Pope. There's a shot of the students, Tom.
Yeah, student section in the
getting the fired up.
Here's old Ramon Zuniga right there. I wish we had the thing.
Yeah, boy, he was a great lineman. You remember that time he's going to kick the extra point?
No, that's his daddy.
But his son.
Oh, yeah.
He was a great ball player.
Old J.R. Goodman.
Was he the one with the shoulder pads on?
Yeah.
All right, here come the Indians. First and 10 now. They're going to run it up the middle, number two, but I think we got illegal procedure, and they do. So Mr. Bobby Willis will back the Indians up. There's a shot of the Indian fans. Man, they all wrapped up on their sideline. Got a good crowd over here for the Indians. Tim was saying that their bus broke down on the way to Homerville. Yeah. Well, he talked to Charlton's head coach, and he says, man, it's just been one of those years. They lost 9 on defense last year and 8 on offense. That's what he had to replace this year. And, well, the good thing about it is when you got a young team, that means you're going to get better.
Yeah, I get it. You know? It's a good way to look at it.
Right. King's going to roll to his left, and he'll find one. He'll pick up Tom 7 yards. Yep. That's going to bring up 2nd and 8 after the penalty. Tom, is little Allen going to Jacksonville tomorrow? Is he taking this year off?
He's taking this year off.
Well, man, he's been to enough.
You know, his old heart's been acting up on him. He said he's not sure he can handle it.
That's right.
Here's the band.
That's Clinch. I thought it was Charlton's band for a minute. Do I recognize some of the kids?
That's Lenora Strickland's daughter right there in the front.
Right. That's her baby. Here come the Indians. They're going to hand it right up the middle. Panthers will stop him after a couple-yard gain. I'm trying to see who it is. Number 7 in there for the Panthers. That is DeLeo Carter on the stop. Man, when you have Hodges and Big Craig in there between both of them, you got 700 pounds just between them two. Hard to run up the middle with that. Indians are chewing some clock here, and I'm sure that's what they want it to do. Because they have been unable to stop the Panther offense tonight. Big third down, 3rd and 6 for the Indians. King takes the snap. He's going to make one miss. He's coming to the right, looking. He's going to keep the ball. Tommy's going to get the first down, plus about 6. Good job in there by King and the Charlton County Indians. So that's their 2nd first down tonight. And, Tom, the series, Clinch leads the series 29-28-1. 129, lost 28,
yep,
tied 1.
Tied
that's
one
about
time.
Even, isn't it, brother? Well, there's a shot. I'm trying to think. That chicken strip looks good.
Mm-hmm. That's the Leroy Kent's twins, I think.
All right. I knew they had to be related. I don't know which one she likes better, the ring pop or the chicken.
Well, she's working on both of them.
That's right. Good combo there. All right, number 2, man, he done a great job.
Flag on the play, must be holding.
That is Lily for the Indians, man. The Panthers had him behind the line, and he cut back and picks up a couple. Here comes big Gus Bryan into the game along with number 8, and that is Gordon.
There's
Statton. A shot. No, Statton Malcolm. No. Mr. Stanley. That Parker Brown.
Gosh. Leave that right there for just a second.
Yeah. Hey, Stanton rolling his eyes. Hey.
Come on. Oh, man.
Tell him to go back. Well, now we got a penalty. Tom always likes to take pictures. Man, we made the Hendrixes famous last week.
Yeah, we did.
Mr. Barry and has went and purchased a shirt for the Hendrixes to wear to I told him, you know, we can get all our sponsors on the shirt.
On the one show on the front. That's right.
All right, here come the Indians. He's going to run it up the middle. This time, big 45 says, nope, I'm going to let you get to the line, and that's as far as you're going. Let's see. It's going to be close, and I think he did. He did. He got the first down. They only needed a yard. All right, Tom. Well, you got your
Y'all aren't ready yet. All right.
We're going to ask you to spell something now. Yeah. Right.
Are you smarter than a fifth grader?
Yeah.
We've got the show coming on. We've got Lori James and Jason Bell coming in the trailer with us. We're going to interview them in a few minutes about the East Blast.
All right. King will hand it off. Good hard running in there by number two, and that is Lily. He'll pick up 5 yards. Tom, the Indians got a good drive going on here.
Well, they better hurry up. There's only 3 minutes and 40 seconds left to go.
Man, and you want to score with no time left if I'm the Indians.
Which they get the ball to start the second half.
Yeah. A score here would make Coach Tyson probably get a little loud at halftime.
Yeah, probably so.
Panthers bring Coach Winston, bring Big Craig in that middle to kind of stuff it up. King with it, and he's going to run the same play, Tom, and they found something that's worked, and he's going to pick up another 10 for the Indians. All the way down to the 20. And that is Lilly. So that offensive line for the Indians doing a good job now. I wonder if Coach Winston's going to get a timeout and just talk to the defense here.
Alan, the Kites are up at Lawrenceville watching Georgia Gwinnett College. They were wrapping up their fall baseball and had to go watch old Tater.
Man, what they said. I bet Kite's cold.
I bet he is,
Lawrenceville.
Too.
Well, we done got Karasu on camera, so I'm sure they're watching. All right, the Indians break the huddle. They are in a spread. And the back this time is way wide to the right. I don't think he's going to run it on this time, Tom. But they've done a good job with it. King, he will. He'll take the snap. He's looking. Panthers are going to get him. He might have made it back to the line.
Number nine. Who's that, Alan?
That is
Carzell Thrower. We've called his name all night. We should know his number by now.
Coach Chase, Coach Tyson, Big Eric Harris there.
Tim with his gloves on.
There's Coach Pope. All the coaches, they don't, none of them have shorts on tonight, do they? All right, the clock's running, Tom. Second and 12 here for the Indians. They stay in that spread. Number two's to the left of the quarterback now, King, and he's going to hand it off to Lily up the middle, and he may have got back to the line. Big Craig Harris on the tackle for the Panthers. Big Austin Peterson
coming out of the middle.
You never would believe this now, but Austin could run about a 6-minute mile. One time. He could be wide open.
Yeah, the whole way around.
205.
I bet he can't now.
No. He told me he can't. I said, Austin, he said, no, I don't run track no more. He did. When he was young, man, he'd come out here, and I told little Winston, I mean, he could run wide open. There's a shot of some of the Homerville fans.
Yep.
That's
Sheikin, Jamela.
Jamela. Looking around. There's Trini. Where's Dooley at? There he is. Got that boggin on. Trini and Dooley, they're here watching Gus. So I don't know who called that timeout. Was it the Indians, Tom? Probably was. Third and 12. 2:05. It's four down territory. They're going to go for it regardless. All right, here come the Indians. All right, they're going to stay in that spread formation. No, you're going to have to talk too, Lloyd. Don't sit up. Here comes. Hey. Oh, and a great sack in there for the Panthers. That's number 7. That is Carter. That's the first sack on King tonight. So the clock is running now. It's going to bring up fourth down. If I'm the Indians, I just let it run. Nope, they're going to call a timeout. I think Little Winston called a timeout. 1:49 here. Jason, come on up here. There's 1:50 to come, and I'm going to leave it to Jason. Let him do the play-by-play for them.
All right, Jason, we've got Jason Bell in the Creek Box trailer with us. He's the director of operations for the school system. Jason, we've been talking a lot about the East Block coming up that's being voted on. That the final early voting's been going on. The final voting is Tuesday. We've talked about it, but you're a lot more knowledgeable about it than I am. So you can tell our listeners tell us a little bit about it and what's going on.
Okay. The first thing I want to make sure everybody knows is who can vote. There's been a little bit of confusion, but we want to make sure that everybody knows that the county residents can vote as well as the city residents. You know, there's some city races.
Yeah, there's city races going on, but you can still go to the courthouse even if you live in the county.
That's exactly
right.
And vote on. We want to make sure everybody realizes that, and that this is not a tax increase. The current SPLOST is about to end. And this is a vote to renew another SPLOST.
Now, how long will it go for?
It'll go for 2 years.
2 years.
And anyway, that's kind of what we want to make sure we educate folks and let them know exactly what that is. And it's not a tax increase. It's just a renewal.
Renewal.
The sales tax would stay the same if it is voted back in.
And it's a sales tax that everybody that comes – it's kind of like the SPLOST for the county and the city gets. Everybody that buys anything, even if they're from out of town –
That's right.
It's not just a local tax. It's everybody that buys gas that comes through Clinch County is spread out that way, right?
That's right. Okay. We heard one statistic that 40% of this money comes from people passing through town.
Yep.
You know, so it's a big draw. It helps everybody share the burden, and it doesn't get just piled on the local taxpayers. Right. So it's a good way to collect tax money from people out of our county. And that way, we don't have to pay as much, you know. And it's just a real big thing. And if it's passed, it would be good to help continue what we've been doing.
Now, the amount of money that it brings in, if it wasn't passed, then it is going to go to the taxpayers, the local taxpayers, because we're going to have to go up on taxes just to make up for this,
that's
right?
That's a possibility. You know, you never know. We hope we don't. But, you know, we would definitely have to tighten budgets and get tighter and start searching.
Or we would lose a lot of things that our school system's getting.
Exactly, we would lose some things. And the kids depend on some of this. And our system is small. Mm-hmm. You know, we're not like Valdosta and larger places. So,
yeah, that's right.
You know, we don't collect as much, but it means more to us. It's more important in our budget.
Yep. All right. Well, I think up next is Lori James, the future superintendent of the school systems. She, I'm trying to unlock my phone to see. Okay, here we go. Hold on. Hold on. All right, get it straight. I got you turned off now. All right, pull the microphone up a little bit. There you go. Yep. All right. Now we got you. All right, Miss. All right, Dr. James, tell us what all it can be used for, what it is used for.
Well, we use this money for a lot of things to support the students in the classrooms. This past summer, all of the kindergarten and first grade classrooms, they've had carpet in those rooms for a long time, so we pulled up the carpet, laid down some tile, painted the classrooms. We also, in grades 3 through 12, we're one-to-one in student Chromebooks. And they use those Chromebooks in the classrooms on a daily basis.
I even had Alden and Ella here talking about the Chromebooks a couple weeks ago.
That's right. That's right. And also, in the classrooms, the technology, you know, the teachers use the smart boards to provide instruction and help provide a more interactive environment. But in addition to that, each school, each campus has over 70 state-of-the-art, high-definition security cameras that I know that the principals rely on a lot to help with discipline and just and keeping up with what's going on in the schools. So that's a big thing. We also buy school buses with it. We've purchased a couple of school buses over the past couple of years. Kitchen equipment, band instruments. If you've ridden by the high school lately, you might have noticed the resurfaced tennis courts.
Yeah.
They look good out there. That happened this summer. The weight room, batting facility, all kinds of things like that.
Things for the facilities, we can use it for that.
That's right.
It's not doesn't go for paying salaries and paying for teachers. It goes for instructional.
That's right.
Material and the facilities.
Right. Cannot be used for any salaries, just things like technology, facilities, safety equipment.
Well, that's great. And the last day of voting is
Tuesday.
So yep. Early voting got over with. And like you said, and Mr. Jason said, anybody can vote in the county. Down in Fargo, I know they're voting down there for city council. You can go vote there. You don't have to live in a city.
That's right.
You can come up to the courthouse and vote. And Tuesday, I think that all of the voting precincts will probably be open. It won't just be in the county.
That's
right. I think. But either way, you can go to the courthouse and vote. And I know that y'all probably can't tell everybody how to vote, but I can. And I'm going to tell everybody that I'm voting. Yeah, I've already voted yes on the splosh, and I'd encourage everybody in the county to do that because it is important for our children's education in the school system.
Oh, that's right.
And even if it didn't raise taxes, if we didn't get it, it would hurt our school system by the things we wouldn't be able to do.
Yes, our students and teachers depend a lot on it, and we appreciate your support.
Well, I thank y'all for coming into the Creek Box trailer. And is there any, Miss James, anything else you want to tell the school system and the listeners watching tonight?
Roll, red, roll.
Roll, red, roll. Let's go Panthers. All right, well, thank y'all.
Thank you.
All right, and we've got 23 seconds left to go. In the first half, Mr. Allen's already – Mr. Jason, you want to do play-by-play the last 23 seconds of the last 23 seconds of the game? I don't know the players either. We got the list right here. Allen and I usually ask Charlton County's, and this is the Clinch County, and half the numbers are wrong, so sometimes we just have to make up names for them. But, well, it's the last few seconds running off the clock. Jason, we've the Panthers are up 21-0, and that's going to be it for the first half. And I think that Tim's probably going to be on the sidelines. It looks like Coach Tyson's down there got him fired up.
That was a good half.
Yeah, that was a good half.
That's how they're supposed to be.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. All right, Tim will be with you in just a minute, and y'all stay tuned in and watch the Panther Band of Pride, and we'll be back after the after halftime. Thank you.
Handful. All right, folks, halftime here. Clinch County 21, Charlton County 0. Coach Don Tyson here, Panthers head coach, going to speak 2 minutes about the first half. Coach, hard hitting first half. A lot of physicality. Your offense looked good.
Yeah, pleased with that. Offensive line's doing a good job trapping them pretty good on the inside right there. So backs running hard. So far, good.
Yeah, defense is good, too. They're strong. They spread you out and try to do a lot of things, and y'all are pretty well contained them.
So far, that last drive, they were pushing us around a little bit. You know, they got two big boys on the line, and they started blocking us up right there. So we may have relaxed a little bit. We're going to have to go address that, you know, because we don't relax. We don't want to relax, especially in this game.
10-4. Coach, appreciate your time.
Thank you.
For the best pizza and wings in town any day of the week, check out Huey's One Stop in Homerville. Drop by, fuel up, and let Mr. Nick Patel and staff serve you some mouth-watering pizza and wings that you won't soon forget. Or just take that favorite pizza and box of wings home. Call 912-487-2338 to order your pizza and wings every Friday night after the game. Huey's One Stop, 193 Church Street, Homerville. Jerry J's Hog and Bones in Homerville is the restaurant for any time of day. Whether it's breakfast, lunch, dinner, or that special holiday meal. From pancakes to pulled pork and chicken salad to ribeye steak, Jerry J's Hog and Bones has the best food and service around. Oh yeah, and don't forget our great catering service. Go Panthers!
Decades of hunting and traveling has led us to this point, putting a new twist on traditional hunting. Starting this fall, from the deep south swamps to the Alaskan mountain range, follow us as we chase our next adventure on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Since 1972, Popeyes has been serving up mouth-watering, delicious, hot, and mild fried chicken and chicken tenders from its Louisiana kitchen. You know about our great chicken, but have you tried our tasty seafood? All of our menu items come with a Southern style all their own. On your way to or after the game, stop by Popeyes and remember we can handle all your special event catering needs. Conveniently located on Memorial Drive in Waycross, Popeyes puts a piece of Louisiana in every single meal. Lee Engineering and Construction Company in DuPont, Georgia has been a part of the community since 1935 and is proud to support Clinch County Athletics. The prayer of the entire Lee Engineering family is that our Lord and Savior will richly bless our schools, community, and nation. Camping World of Valdosta, located in Lake Park, is your one-stop destination for all your camping needs. Stop by to see your dreams of quality time with your family become a reality. Whether it's tailgating with your air-conditioned camper, taking a trip to the mountains or beach with your family, or driving your motorhome to a faraway destination, Camping World has it all. Let us put you and your family in a camper for as little as $99 per month. And remember, when you buy a camper from Camping World of Valdosta, you receive a free Elite Good Sam membership, roadside assistance, and travel assist for 1 year.
You're watching Creek Box TV.
Well, thank you for tuning in to Creek Box tonight to watch the Clinch County Panthers play. You know, a lot of times we get caught up in wins and losses, but at the end of the day, it's all just a game. The only thing that matters in life is, do you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? The Bible says that whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
At Burt CPAs, helping small businesses with their accounting needs is our business. We have offices in Homerville, Waycross, Alma, and Baxley. Burt's professionals are ready to serve you no matter your location. We are your team for accounting, bookkeeping, tax, and financial advice. In Homerville, call firm partner Adam Toll, 912-490-7142. Mike's Golf Carts and Power Sports in Douglas has the cheapest prices in South Georgia and a huge inventory of new and used gas and electric golf carts and off-road vehicles. Mike's also has parts and accessories and proudly serves customers across the states of Georgia, Florida, and Alabama. Whether you stop into our store or shop with us online, we have everything you need for Can-Am, Easy-Go, Club Car, and Yamaha. 0% financing available for qualified customers. Mike's Golf Carts and Power Sports in Douglas, Georgia. Homerville Jewelers on East Dame Avenue is your headquarters for bridal and baby registry. If you're looking for that special gift for the bride and groom or that perfect gift for the new baby, look no further. We also have a variety of diamonds, gold, sterling silver, watches, and necklaces, and can perform jewelry repair. No need to shop out of town. We can supply all of your gift and jewelry needs. Let Vicki Young and staff serve you at Homerville Jewelers, East Dame Avenue, Homerville. Lutz Brown, Pegler & Manley Insurance Agency is locally owned and has been a part of the Homerville, Clinch County community for many years. We make it a priority to know our clients on a personal basis and take pride in customizing insurance coverage for the particular needs of each customer. We offer all lines of insurance, including auto, home, business, life insurance, annuities, and bonds. Lutz Brown, Pegler & Manley Insurance Agency, East Dame Avenue, Homerville. Go Panthers!
The Band of Pride is led by director of bands Anthony McCoy, auxiliary sponsors Stephanie Gaines and Fontella Page, percussion instructor Trey Holloway, color guard instructor Camden Beavers, and dance instructor Macy Stewart. The band is under the field direction of drum major Lindsay Strickland. This year, the Band of Pride is bringing a little Down Under to the field with war dance, a Haka war chant, and a dance from the Maori people of New Zealand. You will see and hear vigorous movements and rhythmic shouting as the band brings this custom-made show for our entertainment. This is a feast
You're watching Backroad Sports on Creekbox TV.
There's a reason why we're South Georgia's automotive superstore.
Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram. Chevy.
Nissan on the east side.
Walker Jones Used Car Mega Center.
GMC.
Coming soon, the all-new Walker Jones Honda.
Toyota.
We've got it all, so why shop anywhere else?
Hi, I'm David Johnson, pastor at Trinity Baptist Church. Man, Jesus has dramatically changed my life. And I want you to know he'll do the same for you if you'll give him that opportunity.
Attention all hunters. Homerville Feed and Seed has all the shelled corn you need to bag that buck this year. Drop by and load up with corn, shotgun shells, food plot products, and everything else you need to make this year's hunting season the best ever. Whether you're a blueberry farmer or a backyard gardener, we have a wide variety of fertilizers and seed for you. There's no need to drive out of town when all the ag products you need are right here at Homerville Feed and Seed, Homerville, Georgia. Winkie's Southern Styles in Homerville is the go-to place for custom embroidery and vinyl transfer designs. Whether it's t-shirts, caps, or special Christmas items, Winkie's will make it happen. Go by our location at 44 East Elna Street in Homerville and see Lenora for embroidery and vinyl transfer. Winkie's Southern Styles supports the Panthers in their quest for another state championship. Go Panthers!
Dairy Queen is a proud part of our local communities and is cheering our sports teams on to championship seasons. Drop by before and after the game to say hello to Mr. Ash and his entire crew and enjoy the full Dairy Queen menu, including our famous grilled burgers, artisan-style sandwiches, and chicken strips. Cool off with our renowned smoothies, slushies, malts, and iced coffees. Try our fabulous desserts and take an ice cream cake home for that special occasion or just to treat the family. Dine in or take out at Dairy Queen locations in Homerville, Blackshear, Folkston, and Fernandina Beach. See you at the DQ.
For the best pizza and wings in town any day of the week, check out Huey's One Stop in Homerville. Drop by, fuel up, and let Mr. Nick Patel and staff serve you some mouth-watering pizza and wings that you won't soon forget. Or just take that favorite pizza and box of wings home. Call 912-487-2338 to order your pizza and wings every Friday night after the game. Huey's One Stop, 193 Church Street, Homerville. Jerry J's Hog and Bones in Homerville is the restaurant for any time of day. Whether it's breakfast, lunch, dinner, or that special holiday meal. From pancakes to pulled pork and chicken salad to ribeye steak, Jerry J's Hog and Bones has the best food and service around. Oh yeah, and don't forget our great catering service. Go Panthers!
Decades of hunting and traveling has led us to this point, putting a new twist on traditional hunting. Starting this fall, from the deep south swamps to the Alaskan mountain range, follow us as we chase our next adventure on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Since 1972, Popeyes has been serving up mouth-watering, delicious hot and mild fried chicken and chicken tenders from its Louisiana kitchen. You know about our great chicken, but have you tried our tasty seafood? All of our menu items come with a Southern style all their own. On your way to or after the game, stop by Popeyes and remember we can handle all your special event catering needs. Conveniently located on Memorial Drive in Waycross, Popeyes puts a piece of Louisiana in every single meal. Lee Engineering and Construction Company in DuPont, Georgia has been a part of the community since 1935 and is proud to support Clinch County Athletics. The prayer of the entire Lee Engineering family is that our Lord and Savior will richly bless our schools, community, and nation.
Camping World of Valdosta, located in Lake Park, is your one-stop destination for all your camping needs. Stop by to see your dreams of quality time with your family become a reality. Whether it's tailgating with your air-conditioned camper, taking a trip to the mountains or beach with your family, or driving your motorhome to a faraway destination, Camping World has it all. Let us put you and your family in a camper for as little as $99 per month. And remember, when you buy a camper from Camping World of Valdosta, you receive a free Elite Good Sam membership, roadside assistance, and travel assist for 1 year.
You're watching Creek Box TV.
Well, thank you for tuning in to Creek Box tonight to watch the Clinch County Panthers play. You know, a lot of times we get caught up in wins and losses, but at the end of the day, it's all just a game. The only thing that matters in life is, do you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? The Bible says that whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
At Burt CPAs, helping small businesses with their accounting needs is our business. We have offices in Homerville, Waycross, Alma, and Baxley. Burt's professionals are ready to serve you no matter your location. We are your team for accounting, bookkeeping, tax, and financial advice. In Homerville, call firm partner Adam Toll, 912-490-7142.
Mike's Golf Carts and Power Sports in Douglas has the cheapest prices in South Georgia and a huge inventory of new and used gas and electric golf carts and off-road vehicles. Mike's also has parts and accessories and proudly serves customers across the states of Georgia, Florida, and Alabama. Whether you stop into our store or shop with us online, we have everything you need for Can-Am, Easy-Go, Club Car, and Yamaha. 0% financing available for qualified customers. Mike's Golf Carts and Power Sports in Douglas, Georgia. Homerville Jewelers on East Dame Avenue is your headquarters for bridal and baby registry. If you're looking for that special gift for the bride and groom or that perfect gift for the new baby, look no further. We also have a variety of diamonds, gold, sterling silver, watches, and necklaces, and can perform jewelry repair. No need to shop out of town. We can supply all of your gift and jewelry needs. Let Vicki Young and staff serve you at Homerville Jewelers, East Dame Avenue, Homerville. Lutz Brown, Pegler & Manley Insurance Agency is locally owned and has been a part of the Homerville, Clinch County community for many years. We make it a priority to know our clients on a personal basis and take pride in customizing insurance coverage for the particular needs of each customer. We offer all lines of insurance, including auto, home, business, life insurance, annuities, and bonds. Lutz Brown, Pegler & Manley Insurance Agency, East Dame Avenue, Homerville. Go Panthers!
All right, Tom, we're back here getting ready to start the third quarter here in Homerville with the Panthers leading 21-0. Good first quarter for the Panthers, but then Charlton tightened up, Tom. Put a good little drive together and threatened, and then the Panthers tried to score before half, and Charlton did a great job to intercept the ball.
Yep. And you had dipped out on me, but yeah, I was in here, man, interviewing Lori and Jason. They did a great job,
great job, man.
Those two, it's a good. Those are a good combo for our school system. They work really well together and do a good job. And not just bragging on it because she's my sister, but they
do. Has nothing to do with it.
Yeah. Well, no. I mean, it's they're both dedicated, you know, and this East Splash really does. I mean, it really does mean a lot to our school system. I think that it would make taxes go up if we didn't get it. It's either going
to
make taxes go up or
it's going to take away
a lot of stuff that our children benefit from. And so, I mean, we've got to, you know, we've got to vote it in.
That's right, man. Daniel, remind us to let everybody know to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We got a lot of people around here watching, and we want to know where you're at and where you're watching from and who you're watching with. So if y'all subscribe, there's a little pooch kick. Zach just lays it over. Charlton will start in great field position all the way to their own 38-yard line. So they'll take over. They finally found some success late at the second quarter, Tom. They ended up with 50 total yards at the half. They had 30 rushing and 20 passing. Panthers had 206 total yards, 201 rushing and 5 yards passing. And you can kind of look at the scoreboard and tell that by the stats. It's 21-0. See if the Indians will pick up where they left off. They're in a spread formation. They've slid in a dirty slot. They're blocking back another good run, Tom. They found something that's working for them, and it's right between the tackles.
Yep. And they were moving the ball very well right before the second. The half was over with.
We got that big sack to back them up, and that helped the Panthers keep them out of the end zone. AC shot me a text and said, there's Lockhart. Jim and Nancy.
I just asked Lexi, I said, hey, when you have time in a minute, will you go get me a Coke out the cooler?
Yeah.
She looked at me, she said, man, you know my legs are broken.
Yeah, man. Well, hey.
She's gotten 5 pieces of pie.
Yeah.
Back and forth, won't go get me a Coke, and my legs is broken.
Tom said, don't act like something's wrong with you.
Yeah, don't act like something. You know you better. Dog girl. Man, I tell you, it's good to see her laughing, man.
Yeah,
it's got that Hanley cutting up,
that's
man.
Right.
It's a good day in a creek box
that's
trailer, man.
It is. There's a shot of some of the Panther fans. I think they're a little cold, Tom.
Yeah. Emily takes me a minute ago.
She's freezing to death.
Yeah.
All right, Panthers will take over. Defense come out and did their job. Panthers have a wing to the right. They're going to run a little lead over there off tackle and pick up maybe a yard. Good job in there by the Indians. Number 12 on the stop, and that is Brandon Wittenberg. Tom, the bands did a great job at halftime. Charlton's got a great band. Man.
Yeah,
they're loud.
They do. Thank you. Got the pregnant woman to go get me one.
Man, either somebody with a broke leg or
something.
A pregnant.
That's right.
And she made Daniel.
Well,
walk
I gave
all
him a comfortable. I gave him a comfortable chair. They got me sitting on this.
Daniel walked all the way to the concession stand and still didn't come back with no hot chocolate. And they're the Panthers. I like that play there. They run the option. Good job by the Indians.
Y'all want some hot chocolate? We send Jimmy after some. We won't bring Daniel any back though.
Pitched it just a little early. We're going to pick up maybe 3 yards in there. Charlton comes out, man. They've coached them up at the half. They're playing some great football here. 21-0, 10 minutes to go in the third. 3rd and 7, big down for the Panthers. Panthers stay in the wing. We have wing to the right. Charlton, 9 men stacked into the box. Michael Walker, great blocking out there off tackle. He'll pick up 15 yards. That plays there anytime the Panthers want to run it. And I think Coach Tyson, Coach Rance, and Coach Richardson, they know that's there, and they're trying to work on some other stuff. I tell you that Panthers doing a great job blocking on that play. They'll move the chain, sitting at the 50 now. Here comes Moorhead in the game. Walker will go out. We stay in that same formation. Nope, a little different this time. We're going to split number 7 out. Carter. Now, Edmonds will come back over, and we're going to have to call a timeout. I don't think – you can tell we're working on some good new stuff. Coach Rance is explaining what he's – on the new formation, and we had some receivers out of the way, Tom.
Yep, Lacey Green's watching from Camp Lugene tonight.
All right.
She's got her mama, Miss Margie, with her tonight up there seeing them grandbabies.
That's right. Yeah, Rick's been by himself this week,
yep.
I think. He's about to starve to death.
I guarantee it. wearing the same clothes for 3 or 4 days. Can't wash anything.
There's Ned.
And that bunch is cold up there, isn't it?
Where's Dooley? There he is. Show that boggin on Dooley's head. There it is. They all wrapped up.
And Lacey, Texas, is cold still in Japan? And what's the weather like for cold over in Japan?
I guarantee you.
There's Jason and Lori and Brent and Heather and Gregory.
And Miss Carla.
Miss Carla.
Looking around. There's Alvin Henderson and Miss Debbie up there.
Are they up there?
Yeah.
I think they moved back to Waycross, hadn't they?
Probably. They come to see Action Jackson at senior night tonight. He's a senior. Had a good run. I started to call you Adam. Number 5 there for the Panthers. That is, let's see, is that number 5? That's DeMondre. All right. Boy, he's quick. Panthers moved the ball again. So it's 1st and 10. Panthers are on the Indians' 38-yard line. All right.
Having a boy.
We'll have a good announcement next Friday then on Creek. Oh, boy. Charlton almost with another pick there. Moorhead didn't get enough air up under it. And great job.
And Matt Nicole Spikes watching from Hiawassee, Georgia. Hiawassee. P. John and Donna watching from Club Med Port at Port St. Lucie.
I wonder if he's going to the Florida game tomorrow.
No, not if he's in Port. Well, I don't know. He might be.
I don't know where that's at. Isn't that around Tallahassee somewhere? All right. There goes man 14 for the Panthers. He'll pick up the Oh, and he lost the ball, and the Indians will recover. He was trying to get extra yards. Let's see what the referee says. Did he say he was down? They're talking about it, of course, all the coaches on the Indian side. I don't know if he stepped out of bounds or what the call is. Oh, they're going to say he was down. Boy, Charlton's coach is hot.
Yeah, I guarantee it.
That was Tiller on the carry, and he picked up a lot of yards, and then he tried to back up.
Morris and Laura watching from home.
All right. Yeah, it was a little cold tonight. Morris wasn't going to come out.
Yep. Frankie just got back from Vidosta buying groceries. He said he's ready for some football.
I bet he bought 5 gallons.
He lets you get us hooked up, though. Okay, all right. Well, he's eating a gallon on the way home.
Panthers are moving the ball now. Up 21-0. Stay in that wing. Wing to the left. Tight end to the left. We're going to throw a little hitch out to Moorhead. Look out. It was behind the line of scrimmage. You got to get on that ball. It just wasn't behind the quarterback. That was close. 2nd and 10 for the Panthers now. This is the 9th game of the season. Next Friday, we'll go to Tail Fair to wrap up the regular season, Tom. And
then we'll have an off weekend, won't we?
That's right. The Panthers, if they win next Friday, we'll be off. They win tonight and next Friday. Panthers going to run right up the middle. Number 6 there, that is Grady. He'll pick up maybe a yard. Here come the Indians again trying to hold them up. It's 3rd and 8 now for the Panthers.
Oh, Randy Stahl is watching from Chester Maddox Road.
All right.
Joey Rich is watching 2019 region champs, Noble Strong.
All right, man. Yeah, we want to give all our prayers out to Coach Noble's over there in Ocilla in Irwin County. They got a great football team.
Irwin's winning 35-0, beating Atco.
Imagine that. This could be Irwin's year. They are loaded. Here come the Panthers. We're going to run that sweep, and we'll pick up the 1st down. Panthers know where the bread and butter's at. We wait, get 3rd and long, and then we'll run right off tackle, and we'll pick up another 1st down. Great blocking again for that Panther line. First and 10 at the 14, Tom. Chewing that clock away. Great shot there from the opposite end zone. Moorhead will take it, run right off tackle again. He runs
They're
over.
Carrying two people with him, Allen.
Another
got
10
down
yards.
To about the four.
Yeah, almost another four. He picked up 9 yards.
Is this right here the first half?
Yeah, that was the first half right there.
Have you already said it? Charlton had a total of 50 yards, 30 passing, and no, 30 rushing and 20 passing.
That's right.
Clinch had 201 rushing and 5 passing. For a total of 206 yards to Charlton County's 50.
And we're getting ready to add 70 more yards to that, it looks like, Tom, rushing. We got an injured man down, Tom. So,
all right, be a good time for us to take a timeout. We'll be back in 25 seconds.
You're watching Backroad Sports on Creekbox TV.
There's a reason why we're South Georgia's automotive superstore.
Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram. Chevy.
Nissan on the east side.
Walker Jones Used Car Mega Center.
GMC.
Coming soon, the all-new Walker Jones Honda.
Toyota.
We've got it all, so why shop anywhere else?
Hi, I'm David Johnson, pastor at Trinity Baptist Church. Man, Jesus has dramatically changed my life, and I want you to know He'll do the same for you if you'll give Him that opportunity.
Attention all hunters. Homerville Feed and Seed has all the shelled corn you need to bag that buck this year. Drop by and load up with corn, shotgun shells, food plot products, and everything else you need to make this year's hunting season the best ever. Whether you're a blueberry farmer or a backyard gardener, we have a wide variety of fertilizers and seed for you. There's no need to drive out of town when all the ag products you need are right here at Homerville Feed and Seed, Homerville, Georgia.
Hi, there's the Panther, Tom. Who'd you say that was?
I don't remember.
The mascot.
Yep.
Doing a great job. Yeah. That's Ganey. Ganey's who you said that was, didn't you? Here comes the Panther, runoff tackle, touchdown. Great blocking. Look at the lineman laying out there, number 6 for the Panthers. That is Grady. Panthers go down the field. It's 27-0 now. Robbins is coming on to try to make
it
28.
Some hot chocolate. Yeah, two of them.
And here's the main man that makes it all happen, Jimmy. Man, he knows. He gets the roster sheet for us now. Everything's set up.
Yeah, Jimmy, man.
Jimmy's the man.
He is the man. Oh, Jimmy Sutton. That's what I got him saved as in my phone.
Is that Jimmy's last name?
I think it's his adopted name.
Okay, I don't know what Jimmy's last name is. There's the kick, and Zach Robbins will be point number 4 for him tonight, Tom.
All right, Alan, we'll take another short break. The Panthers up 28-0.
Winkie's Southern Styles in Homerville is the go-to place for custom embroidery and vinyl transfer designs. Whether it's t-shirts, caps, or special Christmas items, Winkie's will make it happen. Go by our location at 44 East Elna Street in Homerville and see Lenora for embroidery and vinyl transfer. Winkie's Southern Styles supports the Panthers in their quest for another state championship. Go Panthers!
There's the pretty cheerleaders from Homerville. Panthers getting ready to kick off up 28-0. All right, when Zach gets ready, well, I'm going to give a shout out after the kick. There they are. Hey, Brad, they see him walk by and he'll pull up the camera and everybody starts waving. Here comes Robbins. He's backed up about 12 yards. He's going to try to put this one in the end zone. And there he is, a kick, and it's going to go all the way to about the 7-yard line. Number 4 is going to bring it out for the Indians, and he may have got to the 25-yard line. That is Harris on the return. Man, I want to give a shout-out to our sponsors. We have Winkies, Popeyes and Dairy Queen, Lutz Brown, Pigler Manley, Lee Engineered, Homerville Feed and Seed, Mike's Golf Carts, Walker Jones and Nissan, Camping World of Valosta, Homerville Jewelers, Burt CPA, Jerry J's, Hog and Bones, Huey's One Stop. You call in here at the start of the fourth quarter and order your pizza. They're probably with 5 minutes to go in the game, and Huey's will have you hooked up, and that's probably the best pizza in Homerville. So y'all stop by Huey's and get you some wings and pizza. Tell them Creek Box sent you. All right, here come the Indians. King will pull it this time, and he tries to get to the sideline, but no. Number 9 for the Panthers says we're not going to have that, and that is thrower.
Oh, Torrance Boone's watching.
He never misses.
He doesn't. Zakoria Ganey is the mascot's name.
That's it. I
name.
Knew it was Ganey.
If I'm saying that right.
All right, here come the Indians again. Second and 11 now. They lost a yard in their last attempt. Under 6 minutes to go here in the third. King takes the snap. He's looking. Here comes a big rush by the Panthers. Nowhere to go. They'll get him at the 5-yard line. Oh, man, he lost about 20 yards in, Tom, and he's holding his ankle. That's not a good sign for the Indians. Oh, and I know that hurt. They fell on his left ankle. Getting up, trying to stand on it. He's a tough, good-looking kid, man. Jalen King. Was trying to see. He is a freshman, too, Tom. That's what.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
He's a freshman, so in a couple years, he is going to be an athlete. That's going to make it third and 31. They got to get to the rec park to get a first down here. Here's the snap.
I know it.
They're going to run it off tackle, and he's going to pick up 5, 6, 7 yards, but that's going to bring up fourth down. Good job in there by number 10. No, that's 13 for the Panthers, and that is Xavier Trawick on the stop. So the Indians will have to punt again.
4 minutes and 34 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Clinch up 28-0.
You know, the Indians showed a little bit of life right
there. Yeah, they have,
the
Alan.
Second,
I just can't.
You know, they have had a bad penalty, a 15-yard penalty. They thought they had a first down, and then they give up a sack. Boy, they almost got the punt blocked. Good job in there by Moorhead. He'll run up under the punt, fair catch it. The Panthers are on the Indian 41-yard line, already leading 28-0. If y'all know any of the scores around the area, shoot Tom a text. Last score we had on Lowndes and Moultrie was 14-7 Lowndes. There's our cheerleaders.
Yep. Oh, Lee and Jerome's watching, supporting the Panthers from his chair.
Yeah.
After surgery and a chemo treatment.
All
so, man,
right,
we,
man. Jerome, we praying for you,
yep.
Brother. Panthers break the huddle, wing to the right. There goes Walker. Good blocking out there. He's going to cut up. We're going to have a hold. Oh, and that was a hold. I mean, it was.
Man, there's a Torrance said he'd like to give a shout out to every individual that's ever helped him in any kind of way. And, man, we Torrance is another one that, man, there's been so many prayers going up for that fella. I know we do. He's got a great family and a great mama, and Torrance is just always great attitude and, you know, happy to see you and talk to you. And
he's just,
man,
a great inspiration.
He
to
is.
People,
he
Tom.
Is.
I mean,
and he watches every weekend. Man, I'm glad he stays tuned in.
Yeah, he'll watch basketball, baseball,
yep.
To anything that's on Creek Box, he'll watch.
Yeah, that's right.
Man, that was a 15-yard penalty, it looked like. We had about a 12-yard gain, and now it's first and 20. Comes a snap. We're going to run it right up the middle. Good hard run. A good hard lick. Tom in there. And number 13 for the Panthers. That's Traywick. He'll pick up 6-7 yards.
Yo, Vidosta playing north side, winning 28-7.
28-7. The yep. Wildcats turning it up.
Linda Moore's watching. Linda and Mason watching from home, nice and toasty at Wiregrass.
And Matt and Cindy's still out there in the truck watching.
Are they?
Yeah, they got that heater blowing.
Yep. Old Jerome Shard says, what's up? Love seeing Charlton take a beat down. My buddy Jerome.
Yeah, it's been a long time since the Panthers have been up 28-0 on the Indians. I mean, probably since the 80s, Tom. But the Indians, look, they're young. They're going to bounce back. I know their middle school went undefeated this year over there, so there's
really
2-3 years away.
Man, and the middle school basketball team's been doing good.
They
I know the girls and
that.
Boys been good. The boy, I don't know what the girls did the other day, but I know the boys beat Lakeland. Taylor's playing basketball.
All right. Yep. Yeah, Brianna shared something on Facebook. She does the little cheerleaders, I think, for the middle school. Oh, and the Panthers will move again. Dorsey trying to get a head start. Back them up 5.
Lowndes 14 and Colquitt 14 at the half.
Man.
That's a good game going on.
It's loud over there at the Concrete
I guarantee it.
Palace. There's probably around 15,000 people at that game. Panthers, man, they were down there at the 25-yard line, and now it's third, and we got to get to Argyle. Third and 21. We got to get to that bad curve right before Argyle.
Yeah, right before Argyle.
The roundabout, as they
God,
call it.
God, the roundabout. Jeez.
Wing to the left for the Panthers.
Yep.
And again, boy, Coach Tyson's going to have a fit. Game 9, and that's 3 penalties in a row. And the Indians are, Coach Tyson liable to say, just go out there and punt it right now.
Yep, Irwin Atco, 39-0. Irwin's winning.
So now it's going to be 3rd and 26, Tom.
Think you might just go ahead and punt now.
Yeah. Yeah. There's a shot.
There you go, Jamie Nipper.
Walking out, he's headed to the concession stand.
Yep.
He waited till the line come down some. Panthers wing to the left. This time nobody moves. We're going to run up tackle, and Moorhead will cut it up, and he'll pick up maybe 3 yards. Number 6 on the tackle for the Indians, and that is Marcel Maxwell. I'm sure Coach Richardson and Coach Rance and Coach Tyson are going to have a word with the offense there. The Indians, man, they finally got something to cheer about over there. They're fired
up, fired
Tom.
Up. 2 minutes and 20 seconds left to go in the third quarter. 4th and 22 for the Panthers. Maybe they'll fake punt it and run
Can we even?
Robbins up the middle.
Man,
a good high punt,
boy,
man.
Boy, that is a great punt. All
going
the way
fair
down
catch it about the 16.
That was a great punt, Tom.
Oh, so big Austin Peterson coming off the field. He always hustles down there.
He'll give every player 5 when he's coming off the sideline. There's some of the Indian fans across the field. You can tell it's cool. The temperature is dropped now. So the Indians will take over on their own 17-yard line. 1st and 10.
I guess I have been yawning. Somebody told me a little while ago to quit yawning.
You have
I'm
the
yawning.
Whole game.
Man, them tree planters have kind of wore me out this week.
It's that time of year. There comes the Indians.
They're going to
run. Good job by Darius Dorsey in there on the stop. Lilly on the carry again. He'll pick up maybe a yard.
1:50 left to go in the third quarter.
Second 9 for the Indians now. Clock's rolling. Tom, this has been a quick game, though, really.
Yeah, it's only 9:15. Shoot, I might be asleep by 10:30.
You know, we say that, and that'll be a two-hour fourth quarter.
Yeah, the last 2 minutes will last an hour and a half.
Like an NFL game.
Yeah. They're losing 28-0. Going to call timeouts.
Yeah, that's right. Here come the Indians.
He's going good
throw
pass.
A little out. Did he catch it?
I think he did, Alan.
Great job. It's for 6 yards. He laid out for it. That's number 8 for the Indians. Now that's Preston Lynch. And, Tom, he's a senior, 6'195". Good job by King. Tell you what, he don't play like a freshman. So that's going to bring up 3rd and 4 now. This could be the last play of the third quarter. Indians stay in that spread. Panthers in a 4-2. There's Lilly. He's going to take it around the right end. He's trying to cut up. Great job in there by number 9 for the Panthers, and that's the thrower.
There's P. John. Alan, P. John wants a shout out. We gave him one a while ago. He must not have heard it.
Yeah, yep. P. John, he's watching Drake. Yep. Drake has been blocking.
Yes, sir. Drake's been doing a great job.
And I wonder if Drake's going to watch the game tomorrow.
Probably.
Yeah, I know.
I bet he doesn't watch the whole game. He'll turn it off about the third quarter like the rest of them Florida fans.
Well, it's the fourth quarter,
Tom. All right, we finna go to 10. We going to 10?
Yeah, we got
Coach. All right, let's count him down.
Where you at, Boogie?
Come on, Boogie. Come on, Daniel. Get him on there.
Here we go.
All right, 2-1.
All right, folks, three quarters in the book. Clinch County 28, Charlton 0. Charlton's starting to put up a little bit of a fight here. They're keeping the Panthers at bay. Clinch got a little sloppy the last possession. Getting a little chillier out here, but still a lot of physical activity. Good crowd. Everybody's into it. So see if Clinch can wrap this baby up. After three quarters, 28-0. Come on, girl.
Yes.
Get in here. I got some cheerleaders wanting to get a little air time.
Yes.
Yep.
All right.
Go Panthers.
All right. Woo!
Four quarter.
Great job, Coach Carroll. You see the Indian band across the field, Tom. You can hear them. Boy, they got a loud band.
Yeah, well, they're right across from us. So there are all those big tubas pointing at us.
They got 2.
So, Kara Sue in there, right there. Her mom and daddy's up there watching. Tate at his last baseball game for fall baseball this year.
And it's cold. You know, they're ready. I'm sure Tate's ready to take a break. You know, they won't. It'll be about a month.
Yeah.
That's it.
Old P. John said he's going to go to Drake's going to the game. I don't know. You reckon he's going? What game you reckon he's going to go to?
Yeah.
Who's Florida State playing tomorrow? Yeah. You reckon he's going to go watch him?
I guarantee you he's not going to Tallahassee.
P. John said he's going to the Florida-Georgia game, but it's really the Georgia-Florida game.
Oh, Tom, there's another shank by the punter, and I'm telling you it's going to hit the 40. Oh,
ooh,
good job by
Moorhead. Picked it up. Tried to sneak one by him.
You see Drake, there he comes on the field, number 75. That's P. John's boy. Done a great job blocking for the Panthers tonight.
Wilcox and Turner's tied up at 7. Irwin's beating Axon 39-0. Lanier is beating Telfair 27-20.
You know, if Lanier wins tonight and next Friday, there's a great chance they're going to be in the playoffs.
Really?
For the first time ever. Panthers break the huddle. They have wing to the left and overload to the right. We're going to run back to the right.
Just shot great through job. There like a bullet, Alan.
That's Grady again. You know, the Panthers, between Grady, Edmonds, Walker, and Moorhead, that's 4 backs that could start at any high school.
Yep.
You know, which I'm sure that offensive line would said, hey, that, you know, that show that goes to show you whoever runs the ball, we can block for.
Yep, that's right.
Panthers have everybody stacked to the left now, wing and all.
Eric Sutton still watching.
All right, man. Good Walker. He's going to try to bounce it outside. He does a great job to make a couple of them miss and hard tackle there. He'll pick up four tough yards, though, Tom.
Oh, Jerome said FSU's going to lose to Miami tomorrow, just like the Gators are going to do to Georgia.
And Jerome might be right. All right, bye. We'll see you later, dog.
Bye.
Daniel better have leaving, headed to the house. Daniel said she's going home to cook. Yeah.
He said it after she had walked out.
Yeah.
Going home to cook.
Yeah.
She's going home to go to sleep.
She'll call him before he comes home. He'll have to
stop and get something.
Yeah, that's right. There goes the Panthers right up the middle again, and we're going to come up about a yard short, Tom. Fourth and a yard. Let's see what Coach Tyson's going to do here. Pretty sure he's going to run right off tackle over there.
You think?
Yeah. Clock's running, fixing to be under 10 minutes here. I don't know who the Indians finish up with next week.
I didn't realize P. John. No, I'm not going to joke about that, but P. John just is predicting Florida 41, Georgia 14.
Woo!
He must He must have gotten in an accident tonight. They got him on some pain meds.
There goes Moorhead. They just give it to him, fourth and one, and he runs 13 yards and drags a couple to the end zone.
Yep.
Boy, I hope P. John's right. But, you know. Yeah. You know, Georgia has 24 five-star athletes. Florida has none.
Here we go.
On paper, Georgia's two touchdowns better than Florida. I mean, really, they are. But that's when you play the game, Tom.
That's right.
It doesn't matter on paper.
Well, listening to you, they might as well just go ahead and forfeit.
I'm telling
you,
man. I'm telling you. All right, here comes
Robbins.
It'll
be a good game.
That's what I want, just a great game, man.
You want a tie?
Yeah, you know me. I'll go for a tie. There won't be one of them tomorrow.
No, but.
35 to nothing, Tom.
Yep. Man, and I was on the middle school team, got RJ and Taylor and Talbert Kid and the one they call Mister. All them's playing, and Taylor, and I told him the other night, I said, I'll take credit for all those good players. You know, I coached them at the, you know, at the rec park in basketball.
Yeah.
When they were, I mean, I took that bunch and went about 3 years undefeated, Alan.
Yeah, that's right.
And the only time we lost is when you cheated us.
Yeah, well, I mean,
you just basically gave it to the other team.
When the Talbert kid was sick with the flu.
It wasn't so much I knew who to pick.
I tell Don Seals and Tadpole and Scott, look, if they touch them, put them on the free throw line.
And we'd still win. I'd get mad. Don would say, man, you've won every game. He's like, yeah, but I don't want to lose this one. They were all close games.
They
though.
Were, man.
They were.
And, you know, that's why
it was coaching pulled us out right at the end.
That's right. You know, and that's the future of the Panthers, man. That's why the clinch has been so successful.
Hey, he's fixing to kick it over John Bass's house. He's just backed up 20 yards.
And he finally gets up under that one and inside
all the way
the
down
five.
To the five.
You can pretty much count on Robbins to put – oh, good job in there by number four. Finally, everybody on the kickoff
team.
Yeah,
touched him there for a minute. I thought he was going to get by him, Alan.
Coach Tyson's run out there. He's excited to see. He's counting all the – red hats down there hustling on the kickoff. So. You see Langston Hendricks down there tonight. Man, he's done a good job coaching this year.
Yep.
Man, he graduated last year. He's going to school. Oh, he's going to make a fine coach one day here.
Oh, Candy Lott's been watching. Way to go, Panthers. Let's see. Do what?
My Lord.
Oh, man, Telfair's got up on Lanier, 41-48.
Just Lord, Lanier was up by three touchdowns a while ago.
I'd like for Lanier to win.
I would. I'm pulling for Lanier, too, man. I jinxed them, Tom. I'm wanting them to win out so they'll make the playoffs. They got a fine – you know, man, that quarterback's the best quarterback I've seen this year in the region. that they had. He done a good job last week.
He did do a good job.
Must have been a 15-yard penalty, Tom. Man, that was a 30-yard penalty. Don't know what the call was there.
Old Yates Lot said, tell DeMonte Massey his mother sees him.
There's Mandy and I'm trying to look. Boy, your mind always goes blank. Melissa Gilbert.
Well, I was reading text messages.
Oh, and they put it on the dirt, Tom. Let's see if the Panthers got it. Nope, Charlton gets it back. Number two, that's Lily.
Man, you called his name all night long, Alan.
He's done a good job, man. He's had some rough yards there. He's probably between him and King, that's the offense tonight. Them two there, they have every yard for the Indians.
Man, I just want to take a minute and just talk about our community with trick-or-treating. I think, man, that went well the other night. Great. And then we had the fall carnival the other day. That went great. Man, there was a ton of kids out there for that.
Man, David says it's the most people he's
met
with.
Yeah, man, we've got a lot of good things going on in the community. We got to keep it up.
Oh,
ooh, interception,
man,
Adam.
It is. Don't block him in the back. Good job. We're going to try to get it.
Oh, there it went.
Did they throw the flag? 33's mulking.
If not.
Yeah, you're going to get one. Coach Tyson was running out there.
Coach Tyson was running out there to get him. I don't know where he was.
Get off the field. That was close. And that was 33. That is Danny Fontaine.
Yeah, he almost got us a.
Coach Tyson's going to get him.
Yeah, we're going to discuss that one.
Monday during film.
Yeah, we're going to be doing the whatever windshield wiper. What it looked like he was trying to do something, but it.
His daddy would do that. You knew you'd done something wrong when he'd back it up
over and over.
I'm sure he does the same thing. And did they throw the flag, Tom? They're backing it up. They must.
They might have. Oh, Craig Gaines.
He decked out and I got a sweatsuit on.
Yep, sweatshirt on.
Yeah, Tom, man, y'all have done a great job with the city, and it's getting better and better, man.
It is. Man, I know the police department's been working good. They've made several arrests this week. You know, had a lot of break-ins.
And they've made
some arrests this week. And,
you know, it's like this everywhere. They were talking about in Manor and
it is,
Waco.
Man.
This
it happens
time of
every
the year.
Year starting in November.
That's right.
It happens. And usually, though, Alan, it's a lot of people just walking and checking doors.
That's right.
You know, checking car doors.
That's right.
But this year, it's just something happened, man, and they were breaking in houses. But I think they've made some good arrests and recovered a bunch of stolen items. And, man, we took a couple of our officers and did nothing but just work that. We called in some more people to help patrol, staying in the neighborhoods, and I mean that's what it takes. And Tom, the more the community sees that, the more they're helping with it. You know.
And Tom, do people if they see somebody strange like that, you just want them to call the police department?
Yep, just call 911.
You know,
and they'll come and check it out. And if it's nothing, it gives our police officers an opportunity to talk to somebody.
That's right.
You know, and see what's going on and be involved, and if it is something, then there they are to stop it.
That's
you know,
right.
So just call the 911. They'll send the police department or sheriff's department. Everybody's working really well together. Bunch of good people in the sheriff's department too, working hard.
And you know, you got to lock your vehicle.
You do.
You
got to lock your vehicles, lock your doors in the house.
That's right, man. You got to do it nowadays. You just have to.
Man, that old house of mine that burned a while back, I didn't even have a key to it, Alan.
I know it. No, but now you have to lock it up,
you
man.
You got to lock it up.
It's like that everywhere.
Yep.
Tom, we're getting late, fixing to be under 6 minutes. Panthers up 35-0, man. We want to remind everybody to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Y'all let Daniel know where you're at. We're trying to get our numbers up. Man, we got to give Mr. Barry a shout out. And Brad, they've done some great camera work tonight. And Jimmy had run back in two and set up and laid out about 5 miles of cord.
I guarantee it.
You just don't show up and do this. It takes a couple of hours to set this up to work. There goes Walker around the left end. He's going to pick up the first down, and he'll step out of bounds. I'm sure Coach Tyson was wanting. We got Dozier there saying a little carried over after that. I'm sure Coach Richardson's probably fixing
it. Yeah, I mean, we're winning 35-0. Yeah. I mean, now is not the time to.
Because it'll affect next week's
game.
Yeah,
that's right. You know, I mean, we can't. And our kids know better than that. I mean, you can't let something like that affect you and make you lose. You got to keep it cool about you.
Valosta was winning. They're winning 41-7. Lexi said so.
It's kind of handy having Lexi in here. She can look stuff up for us. Kind of like her own little personal Google.
That's right. I wish we'd had Google when I was in school.
I do, too.
I'd have been an honor graduate. Oh, ooh. We got a flag here. I think it's going to be holding on the Panthers. He's pointing, and all the linemen's hiding.
Yeah. It wasn't me. It wasn't me.
Holding against the Panthers. He's talking to – nope, and he's talking to Hodges. So Hodges saying, it wasn't me. No, that's not Hodges. Who is that? That's 70. Let me look right here.
78. Who?
That's Amari.
That's Amari,
78?
Yeah.
No, 74. DeMonte Massey.
Okay.
If it's 74. 64 is Jamarcus Marshall. He's had a great game tonight. 78, that is Hodges.
Man, that quarter of a bowl of chili is giving me indigestion.
Yeah. Two chili dogs.
No, I didn't have two chili dogs. Don't start it.
Two bowls of chili.
Hey, I'm saving them wings. Ooh, get a pass down the field.
Man, what a.
Oh, man.
Tom.
It in and out of his arms, Allen.
Bounced off his numbers. I mean, Moorhead couldn't have put
it. Great pass.
That was. Right there.
Boom.
You got, man. I got to give number six credit for the Indians. He's got there and got a hand on the ball.
And our guy was running backwards, Allen. I mean, it.
We got another penalty on the Panthers. It must be holding again. And, Tom, they're stopping the clock. You know, the game was at
9
o'clock.
5 minutes and 33 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter.
Jackson's getting the lineman straight.
Man, in a couple of weeks, Allen, we're going to have Homerville for the holidays coming up.
That's right, man.
Yep, finna be decorating the town.
Have Santa Claus coming to town, man. That's an all-day event. Starts that morning, man.
Finishes up that night with a parade.
Man, that's I love this time of year when we have the carnival. And you remember years ago we did what was it called? They started, we finally stopped it. When
Timberland.
The Timberland.
Yep.
But, now with the carnival and
Instead of one big thing, we do
that's
several.
Right.
You know,
like
we do the fall carnival. We do something
fourth
in the spring.
July.
We do the 4th of July.
Right.
And, you know, and they used to do fireworks for the Timberland. Now we do it for the 4th.
That's
you
right,
know,
man. And that thing just keeps getting bigger and bigger every year.
That's right.
Oh, Moorhead will pull it. We're going to run the option. He's looking. He's going to cut up. He'll get the first down. Well, I like that play there.
Yep.
He finally got enough room. You've got to stay to the left of the quarterback.
Yep.
Just keep your eyes on him. That puts that corner in a bad position, or he's got to pick. All right, do I go to the quarterback? And if he goes to the quarterback, Moorhead's just going to pitch it.
Yep.
So it's a dangerous play there. I like that. Coach Rance, Coach Tyson put in. Panthers break the huddle. We're under 4.5 now. Clock's running. Right up the middle. Good blocking in there. He's going to bounce it.
Just bouncing off. Man,
still going. Oh, a good hard block right there at the end. Who is that that got in there? Big Dozier come in and laid it like a bulldozer.
Yes, sir.
Hey, And I know that hurt. Mm-hmm. It made me hurt in here. Boy.
All right, Alan, they got a man down, so we only got 4 minutes left. Now might be a good time to go to commercial. We'll be back in 20 seconds.
Dairy Queen is a proud part of our local communities and is cheering our sports teams on to championship seasons. Drop by before and after the game to say hello to Mr. Ash and his entire crew and enjoy the full Dairy Queen menu, including our famous grilled burgers, artisan-style sandwiches, and chicken strips. Cool off with our renowned smoothies, slushies, malts, and iced coffees. Try our fabulous desserts and take an ice cream cake home for that special occasion, or just to treat the family. Dine in or take out at Dairy Queen locations in Homerville, Blackshear, Folkston, and Fernandina Beach. See you at the DQ.
There's little George Raymond. Boy, Scott's getting sleepy, rubbing his eyes. Hey, leave it right there. Take
leave
a picture.
It right there.
Hang on. Take a picture.
God, I can't get my phone out quick enough.
Tell
Hold
Brad
on.
To leave it there.
Here we go.
He's sleepy.
He's yelled. Oh, I got him.
You got
I
him.
Got him.
Get that. He's looking.
Man, we ought not to do that to me.
Send it to me so I can send it to him.
Which one? I can look at that one right there.
Yeah, that's the one. That's the that one. Send that one. There he is
again.
Now they know they got him. He knows he's on that. Smile, Scott, you old candy camera. Send it to
me. I got about 10 pieces of him.
Give me the sleepy eyed one.
Yeah.
Oh, the Panthers trying to score late here, Tom. You can tell it's me and you got silly here. 35-0. We like Brad does a good job when the game's kind of getting out of hand. He does a great job getting it. There's
a shot. Something to talk
there's
about.
Eric, there's Beth. Beth saying they got the camera on them. Panthers break the huddle. We're going to run it off to the right. Good job. He picking which hole he wants to go. He's going to make it. Good. The touchdown. I think he got in. Yeah, he did. Number 6. That is Grady. He just, look, he lets his blocking catch up with him. Great job. You send it to me?
Yeah, it's coming. I got one of them with his eyes closed, one of them smiling, one of them looks all sleepy.
I'm waiting on him to come in. We've made Scott Lassie's famous. He can join the
– Yeah, him and the Hendrixes.
You know, Jamie, I told Lexi today I was going to get them shirts made with Jamie's was going to have MR – and Bill was going to have Biggins. And when they stood up, it's a M.R. Biggins.
Said M.R. or it say we are. We are Biggins. Look at it. All right, Alan, we scored and kicked the field goal. All right, we'll take a break. And we'll be back in 20 seconds.
For the best pizza and wings in town any day of the week, check out Huey's One Stop in Homerville. Drop by, fuel up, and let Mr. Nick Patel and staff serve you some mouth-watering pizza and wings that you won't soon forget. Or just take that favorite pizza and box of wings home. Call 912-487-2338 to order your pizza and wings every Friday night after the game. Huey's One Stop, 193 Church Street, Homerville. Jerry J's Hog and Bones in Homerville is the restaurant for any time of day. Whether it's breakfast, lunch, dinner, or that special holiday meal. From pancakes to pulled pork and chicken salad to ribeye steak, Jerry J's Hog and Bones has the best food and service around. Oh yeah, and don't forget our great catering service. Go Panthers!
All right, Alan, want me to text you? It takes you 20 minutes to text something.
I can't. Man, you know, Daniel's the one that can text, brother. He can do it. All right, Tom, 41-0. Man, if y'all know the last time the Panthers have beat Charlton by 40 points, Scott said there was something in his eye.
Yeah.
Well, Scott, you had both eyes closed.
Yeah, that's right.
Coach Tyson fired up. He'd kick off coverage team, hustling down the field.
Hey, man, I just saw on Facebook where the governor said that he's made a friendly wager with the Florida governor, Ron DeSantis, whatever his name last name is, but Georgia wins. The governor of Florida comes to South Georgia for some hog hunting. If we lose, our governor's going down to the Everglades to hunt pythons.
All right, man. Yes. I'd rather
hunt that hog than the pythons. Yeah. I can tell you that right now.
You can't see them.
They say some of them pythons have made it up at Okeechobee. I've told them, if I ever find one around my bee yard, somebody can have them bees, I'm coming to South Georgia. Old Frankie said, y'all leave the yard man alone.
Yeah. Oh, Scott, he was looking for his youngin' earlier at halftime. I don't reckon he's found him yet.
He's probably gone home with Mr. Danny and Mr.
Yeah,
Jean.
That's right. I sent every one of them pictures to him. Charlton, still, you know, they're still fighting.
They're running hard,
yeah, man. Number seven.
3 minutes and 40 seconds left to go. And, man, I just want to take another chance, another opportunity to put a plug out there for the East Splash. Everybody go vote. Just go vote.
And that is when now, Tom?
What if, you know, the election's Tuesday. Oh. Early voting got over with today. And I think there's been a good bit of people vote.
Well,
yeah.
Good, man. Now, when's the next election after this, Tom? Is it next year?
Yeah, it'll
they'll
be
have
next
the
year.
Election.
Yep.
That's when they'll have the, I guess, the presidential. We'll have the sheriff election. Yep. All the, got, now, we have a council election coming
no,
up?
No, not
too?
Next year. Not next year. There'll be several school board seats and county commissioner seats and sheriff's race.
Man, I want to give a shout-out again to our sponsors because they are the ones that make this possible for me and Tom to come here and bring some great high school sports here in rural Georgia to you. We got Winkies, Popeyes, and Dairy Queen, Lutz Brown, Pigler & Manley, Lee Engineering, Homerville Feed & Seed, Mike's Golf Cart, Walker Jones of Waycross, Camping World, Homerville Jewelers, Burt CPA, Jerry J's Hog & Bones, and Huey's One Stop. If you call right now, he'll have your pizza ready by the time you get there, man. Indians trying to run out the clock in 2:30.
Man, at one time, and I don't remember exactly what it was, but when it was back when Mr. Butch Hughes owned Huey's, it was before pizza. That's the reason Pizza Hut came.
That's right.
Was because Huey's was like sold more pizzas than of that brand. I mean, than almost anybody else in Georgia. They sold so many, and because they sold so many is why Pizza Hut came.
Brad knows to get a shot of his best
time.
Yep,
that's right.
Lori.
Misty McQuigg.
Oh. And see, Coach Dickerson eat pizza every Friday, and he got them from Huey's every Friday, 60 pizzas.
Up, intercepted it, Allen.
Man,
touchdown, that's Moorhead.
That's going to make it 48.
48 to nothing.
Oh, man, it just went through his hands. That wasn't on the quarterback, man. That went off the receiver's hands a little high. Moorhead will run it in. Coach Chase will be tickled about that. He's the secondary coach. That'll bring Robbins back on the field, and that'll be field goal or extra point 7 if he makes it, Tom. I'd like to know how many points Robin has this year.
He's got a bunch.
You know, and he's got to hold the record for a kick.
Oh, absolutely.
Points,
you know? There ain't no doubt about it.
That's something I need to ask Lynn. I'm sure Lynn knows. Zach's count up. Panthers are one short. We got him running on late. Number 77 for the Panthers.
Blow the whistle and back us up. Maybe not. Here we go.
He puts it down. Robbins. Oh, and we jinxed him, Tom.
No, that wasn't Robbins.
Oh,
Robbins
okay.
Robbins was holding. That was next year's kicker. That's Montgomery, I think.
Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Getting him a little practice in.
You know, look at the Charlton crowd. They're still
sticking
around.
Yeah, still there. Yeah. 48 to nothing. Minutes 50 left to go.
And next week, me and Tom will make it up to Tell Fair, go through Douglas, what, about 30 minutes outside of Douglas?
Yeah, I reckon.
And we'll ease up that way. Yeah, and if Lexi wants to go, she's more than welcome to ride with us. Good crowd here. This is the last regular season home game for the Panthers. Now, of course, if we win next Friday, we should be able to host at least one, maybe two games, Tom.
Yeah.
We're looking
and
at –
and we'll have all, an off week.
That's right. We'll have an off week and then start the playoffs. And talking to Jamie Hendricks, which he knows the power rankings, we're – with the way we're setting it, of course, all the region champions will be seated like 1, 2, 3, 4. If there's five, you know, they'll be we'll fall to six because Earl.
Allen, it got by him. He picked it up at the 10.
And everybody's there. Oh, and he got by him.
Ooh.
Oh, who was that, that's Tom? Trying to see what number
hey,
that
we
was.
We got a replay on that.
Well, that was a good lick, and he's.
And then somebody else got.
Oh, man, he laid out.
That was, oh, almost man. Should have been a flag right here in the corner, too.
23 for the Panthers, and that is – let me see who that is. That is Crispin Dunbar for the Panthers. Hustled down there and made a good hit. But if the Panthers finish, say, fourth, there's a chance we could. There'd be three region champions. That'll put Irwin number one. With Pelham number two, I don't know who'll be three, but we'd be fourth. We could have two home games in the playoffs and then have to go to Irwin in the final
really?
Four. Yeah. You don't want to finish fourth.
We wouldn't
you
meet Irwin
finish.
At
– No, if you finish fourth, you want to finish third or fifth.
Yeah.
You know, to be across the bracket from Irwin to not see them till you get to the finals. Which I'm going to tell you, man, Pelham's averaging over 60 points a game.
Really?
So, you know, you're either going to have to go through
wow.
Irwin or go through Pelham. You know, that's going to be the number one and two team in the state. Now, Pelham's got a big game next Friday. They'll play Mitchell County. And I think Mitchell's ranked somewhere around fifth. That'll be for the region championship. We got a Indian down number seven.
I tell you, Allen, if anybody needs any reading glasses, just stop by the Creek Box trailer because
yeah.
Allen's got 10
no,
pair.
I put these on my jackets. I don't have none at the house.
You got a pair in your jacket, one on your head, three on the table, and one on your face.
You mean tell you what's bad? There's still less than $5 worth of glasses in here.
Man, I had to go get contacts the other day.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, is that the first time you ever had them?
No, well, I had laser surgery when I was about 19. So I had contacts through high school. I was blind. I couldn't read the big E.
Man,
you know when you take the just when they put one letter up there, I couldn't even read that back in high school.
That would be I need glasses really more than reading. There's Darius Dorsey. There's a shot of the.
Charlton
Indian
County
camera
crew.
Been a long night for the Indians.
Long night for that guy. It's cold up here.
Yeah. You know, they'll drive back across the swamp, back into Folkston, and they'll finish up their season next week, and then they'll be ready for basketball.
Yep.
And don't count Charlton out, you know, for the next – they're rebuilding. Their coach is going to do a great job. Give them a couple
and
years.
And look, Charlton County's like Clinch County.
Yeah,
football's part of just the community. The sports and the youth is just part of the community over there. They're not going to.
They're one of the winningest programs in the last 25
that's
years
right.
than any. You know,
that's right.
Coach Mack stayed there for 20-something years, and then he stepped aside and went up to North Georgia, and now they have a new coach. It's a going to rebuild them and do his thing. You got Panthers players all excited. I don't know if they're hollering if they dump some Gatorade. There goes Big Eric Cairns.
Yep. He covered his face up when he walked by the camera.
We got
he knows we'll get him.
Is Coach Carroll going to get Coach Tyson?
I'm sure he will after the game.
Daniel, there's 1:29 left. Indians take a snap. They'll hand it off to number 20. He's got a good run. He's quick, too, Tom. We'll kick him out of bounds. He'll pick up 12 yards. Number 20 is Amarion Woodard. So they'll move the chains. A minute 19 to go. Man, we appreciate everybody tuning in. And, man, when y'all send Tom a text, and that's what I enjoyed, to find out where everybody's
watching. Yeah, where everybody's watching from. And that's what that's the great thing about Creek Box, man. I mean, there's people being able to watch. You know, we had somebody in Saudi Arabia.
That's right.
Watching family members on senior night. Man, I mean, it doesn't get any better than that. That's right. That's what we do it for.
What did you say? Moultrie 17, Lounge 14. Colquitt 17, Lounge 14. 7 minutes to go. Boy, that's a good game.
Ooh,
oh,
come
great
on.
Job. 42. Tom, he come up there. He wasn't going to let him get by him. 42 is Amarion McCray. Man, he come up and played a great job there at corner. All right, Daniel said Tim's.
That's going to fix the winder down. 45 seconds left to go. Clinch up. 48 to nothing.
Should be the last play here, Tom. Not unless we call
it. Irwin County's got three timeouts. I hope they don't use them right here.
We're under 25 now. King will take the snap. I don't think the running back wanted it.
Yeah, Panthers
will hit him, and he'll lose about a half a yard, Tom, and I think that's going to do it.
Going to wind her up, Allen.
So Coach Tyson is 1-0 against the Indians now.
All right, like you said, we're going to be where are we going to be next week?
Telfair.
McCray, Georgia next week.
Coach Tyson remind them to shake their hands and act like you got
and
some smarts.
Calm down. And, like I said, the Panthers need to win next week. If they do, maybe they'll have the bye the following week.
And, man, I'm going to tell you, it's whenever you go to Telfair, they're dangerous at home. You know, anything can happen. You've got to prepare and be ready, and Coach Tyson will get the team right. But, man, we'll be back, what time, 7:20 next Friday?
7:20 next Friday night, pregame show. We'll be there.
Tom, man, I've enjoyed it, brother.
Yeah, I have, man, and it's been great having Lexi in the trailer with us.
Man, that's right. We're finna go cut that heater on in the truck. Ease to do.
I guarantee you are. But anyway, all right, we appreciate everybody tuning in. God bless y'all. Thanks for watching Creek Box, and we'll see y'all next week.
You're watching Backroad Sports on Creek Box TV.